Hello, everybody, and welcome back.
Welcome back to the post-credit show for February 25th, 2017.
If you're trying to watch us on YouTube, apparently there's some issues going
on.
We're
having some issues. Other people are having some issues.
It's not just us.
We've learned science.
I feel bad because it's not working, but at the same time...
But it's not so bad that it's not just us.
Yes, I don't feel bad because, yeah, it's
a...
We've done everything we can do.
We've reset the keys, we've done, yeah.
We have troubleshooted to the max, so you're stuck with us on...
Twitch and Hitbox.
Twitch and Hitbox.
Hello, welcome back.
So, there
it
we go.
It is, wow.
6 a.m.
Wow, thanks for joining us. This is your morning news. You've elected not to watch your morning news.
To join us.
Thank you.
Thanks.
I feel honored.
This is one of those. See, this is the reason I looked into starting a satellite radio program. People, can you imagine people listening to us in the car on the way to work? So today,
live poops.
For those of you, barrel roll morning news. Oh man,
this is if you're just joining us now. This is the post-credits show where we talk about what it is we've done, games we've played, movies we've watched, things we've experienced. It can be short.
Thank goodness.
We are short a head or two. So.
Yeah, we really are, and we can discuss the Inhumans movie stuff.
Yeah, we can talk about that.
That Greg brought up. So if you guys have questions for us too, we can talk about those.
Yeah, now's the right time to fire them off. We'll answer as much of them as we can.
Especially because I know I didn't. I'll start.
Okay, let's begin.
Brian and I played some Overwatch this week. You and I played some Overwatch.
We did play some Overwatch.
I'm not good at that game.
Sometimes I'm really, really good. Sometimes I'm not so good. I think it's all about team synergy, like Heroes of the Storm is.
Very much so.
It's all about team synergy. So if you have a team that's not,
yeah,
you know, if you don't have any damage, then you're not getting anywhere, right?
Same
thing with Heroes of the Storm.
So Brian and I played some Heroes of the Storm. And I guess I played some games last weekend, so that counts for now.
Yeah.
Yes! So I played To Be or Not To Be.
Yes, I think I still want to play that game.
It is a choose-your-own-adventure storybook that's narrated.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no... I was expecting, like, scenes
mm-hmm.
to play out. There's no scenes. It's literally just dialogue boxes that keep popping, and you choose what happens.
Did you get a feel of a little bit of a... Stanley Parable dialogue going on?
Sort of.
Because from the bit that I saw, and you can catch up with it on our archives on YouTube. But it felt like a little bit of narrator that was kind of being very liberal in the way he was presenting the information.
For sure. And I think that honestly, this would be almost a good way of doing Hamlet for high school kids. Like it's an interesting way of presenting Hamlet to people who have never done Shakespeare before. Because it does, there's little skulls that appear for the choices. If you pick to play as Hamlet, because you can play as Hamlet, Ophelia, or Hamlet's father.
Mm-hmm.
So you play as a ghost. If you play as Hamlet, there's little skulls that appear, and that is Hamlet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You can go through the story of Hamlet without problem.
You guys watch JK News?
No.
I'm not sure.
But no, so you can go through the entire story of Hamlet with this guy essentially explaining, like, oh, dude, like, your dad's a ghost now.
Yeah.
How weird is that? And you go, it is weird.
Do they ever, like, put down the throat of, like, all the Shakespearean dialogue?
No.
Okay, so it's a good entry point.
It's a very good entry point if you've never done Shakespeare. Now, I've done Shakespeare, so for me, it's funny as a person who knows
what they're actually trying to say.
And then, again, the choose-your-own-adventure part is you can totally screw up the story. Which is exactly what I did.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, for one point in time, it's like, oh, does Hamlet go back to school? Which he's supposed to, like, choose to almost go back to school, and he's supposed to choose to do this. And I'm like, I sit upon my throne as prince. And then it's like, okay, you're kind of bored of this now. What do you do until nighttime? Because your friend tells you to come to the parapets at night to, like, you know, there's a ghost that's been hanging around. We're pretty sure it's your dad. Like, come and see us.
Yeah.
And it's like, what do you want to do to, like, pass the time? And you can go play as Ophelia, so that would carry on the story of Hamlet, where you actually see what she's up to. And I'm like, I choose to play solitaire in my room till nightfall. And that's what I did. So that's like, Hamlet pretty much sat in his room doing nothing until nighttime came. Then I went to meet the ghost, and I chose to stare at it until I passed out. In which case, I became my father, and you're supposed to try and wake yourself up, and I'm just like, I'm just going to talk to... as the father of, I'm just going to talk to my buddy, Horatio, and give him the news to tell Hamlet, and hope that, and then it's like, and now that your news has been passed on, you start to, like, cross over into the, like, you know, nether realm, and you hope that everything turns out okay, game over. And I'm like, all right, I appreciate that. And then it gives you a to be or not to be, like, how close did you get to actually succeeding in the storyline of Hamlet? And I, of course, got, like, not to be, because I got nowhere in that game. And I'm like, that's a game I'll play by myself. I'm not going to stream that one.
No. I feel like it looked a bit more of like a mobile game as well.
It really could have been. Yeah. And then I played, and I can never get this one right, an explorer type game.
We did get a chance to play your game, Jake. Test drive it, run it.
We did. I liked the wheelchair. We liked the wheelchair part.
Yes.
We thought that was intriguing.
Yes. I think the camera control was kind of confusing at first.
Yes, but it made sense once we knew we were in a wheelchair.
Yes. So.
Because you rolled around like a tank more than
anything. It felt like almost a VR.
Yes, kind of experience. That's also what you, we mentioned
it VR. It felt like experience. A VR experience, if that's what you want to go with, which, totally cool.
Yeah. And then we got stuck down that pit.
Yeah, there was a pit in the back.
And then we tried trying to figure out what the pit symbolized.
Yes.
Because as English majors, maybe, that's what we have to do.
Maybe it was a sense of finality that you can't get out.
Then we just can't get out of this rut that we're in.
Crippling student debt.
But no, Jake, there was some really cool stuff going on in that,
and it looked game. I'm surprised that was in Unity, right? Was that Unity?
That was Unity.
Was it Unity?
That was Unity.
Yeah. Unity. Yeah, super cool.
We were very... I was impressed.
Work on it some more. Definitely.
Yes, for sure.
That Explorer game.
The Explorer game. It's got a name. I'll post it later.
Hold on.
I can just open my Steam.
No.
Too late.
Found it.
Send a link for you guys for later. Thanks, dude. Yeah, we'll keep checking it out as you update it.
You played Renowned Explorers.
That's the one. Renowned Explorers.
Of international... Oh, not of, but International Society.
Yeah. So essentially, this is a roguelite game, they called it, which it's very much not. Because there's nothing that carries over. It's very much a... you pick three people, and they all have varying stats. And you essentially have five explorations to become renowned, like the best explorers you can possibly be. And every time they unlock harder and harder explorations... Mm-hmm. So I streamed and I streamed and I streamed, and finally I shut it down. I shut down the stream, and I'm like, okay, I'm going to play one more off stream, just
figure it out,
just to try some other stuff out. And I made it past all five things, because when I streamed, I kept either like losing to cultists, or I didn't end up getting a big treasure from this tribe, and I ended up, I think, joining some African tribe.
This game sounds a lot like Tharsis, except the sort of a...
The mechanics Oregon are very trail. Different because you actually have to choose how you interact with the people you run into. Mm. So you can beat up bad guys by being nice to them.
Okay.
Or you can beat up bad guys by being, like, a bully. Mm-hmm. So if they're really aggressive to you, you can sit there and call them a poopy pants, and they'll lose the will to fight and run away.
Just like real life, yes.
So, and if people are super duper nice, you can beat them up way easier because they come up to you like, hey, welcome to our village!
Sucker punch!
And yeah, you essentially, like... I picked the big Russian dude as my bruiser, and he just, like, his animation is just, like, he puts his book away, and then just, like, whoosh, and his fist is, like, that big compared to everything. So it's, like, the Hulk fist coming at you and just, like, whacking you in the face, and stuff just falls over, and it's, like, I don't want to play aggressively, so you really have to choose how you want to play. You get so many...
It sounds like there might be even a reputation system in there as well, where it's, like, you know, the more...
Yes and no. So you do actually get different rewards depending on how you finish a fight.
Yeah.
And it's a Catan-style map, so it's very, like, you've got the quadrants.
Hexagonal.
Yeah, and you have so many rations to make it through to your end goal. And you don't have to have rations, but you start losing stats as you have no rations.
Yes.
You can pick up more rations on certain maps. So you can kind of, like, I got on my one map on the game that I wasn't streaming, where I made it through, like, I explored most of the map because I kept running into rations at just the right times where I'm like, okay... I'm counting squares going.
Do you have to hunt for anything?
Nope.
Okay.
You have to solve puzzles essentially by rolling wheels and having specific stats. It's very almost D&D kind of rolls, board game stats. So I have a really good stat in talking. And on the map I can see that I'm going to have to use like some kind of talking skill to get through this part of the map.
Mm-hmm.
if I don't have anyone that can talk, I should probably avoid that area of the map because I'm going to lose.
Right.
So that's kind of the way it works. It's an interesting game, and I had fun with it. And now the trick is to try and get to be, like, the top explorer. Because on my game that I played, I think I became the third top explorer. Because I had one exploration left, and I'm like, I am so close, I don't want to die. I just want to see how this game kind of ends. So I went for a really easy mission for my last mission instead of a difficult one. And the difficult one obviously would have given me greater rewards.
High risk, high reward.
Yeah. So, yeah, I played those ones. To be or not to be, I would honestly, if you're in high school, suggest it if you're going through Hamlet.
Yeah.
Because it gives you a good gist of the story. And the Explorer one, Renowned Explorers, is pretty fun. If it's on sale, I would not pay full
did
price.
Did you get it on the bundle?
No, I got it on Steam. It was like 50% off, so I think I paid $5 for it.
Mm-hmm.
It was worth the $5. Like I got easy $5 out of it.
Mm-hmm.
And then I bought the expansion pack because it gives you more places to explore.
Mm-hmm.
So that was another like $3, and I'm like,
yeah, $8.
$8 for a game that I played for a solid like 4 hours, and will play again at some point once I figured out more of the mechanics. But and I picked the Canadian because the people are all from different countries, so. Thanks, Jake. We'll
do it again.
Yeah. Other than that, I watch more Riverdale.
I don't think that show's going anywhere. It doesn't feel like it's going anywhere.
No
one's really talking about it anywhere at any point, because I remember the hype going into it.
No. And
that really, really large.
I don't know. Riverdale's a very... I think the cast would be really good in a comedy. Like, I think if they made it a quirky comedy, you
maybe,
keep the same
maybe they
cast.
Signed up thinking it was a comedy, and then they got the real script.
It's an Archie show. And this one, Archie gets upset because the teacher he was sleeping with moved away because they got found out. And so he's up in his room using a punching bag, and I'm like...
That doesn't sound like Archie.
Just doesn't seem
if anything,
Archie.
That would be Jughead. That would be Jug. Yeah.
No, Reggie's the muscle head. Jughead's the eater.
Yeah, but the way that you've... I'm watching a movie while listening to you. Wow, you've got some really good multitasking skills, Greg.
We've thought about doing that, Greg, as an actual podcast, watching movies and talking over them.
We did that with the game.
We've done that. Oh, yes. We've done that with games.
Two or three games, maybe. But I think
we used to do it with movies when we did the movie nights at our university.
No, then the people just yelled at us.
Sometimes. We got one good night. We were watching an X-Men movie.
Which one?
I don't remember.
Those nights were a vague, like...
All I remember was we weren't up in the main room. We had to use classrooms downstairs, and we separated games and movies, and the movie room, we kept making comments over top of whatever movie it was, and people were actually laughing, so we just kept going. Don't give us an inch. We'll take it the whole mile.
Especially if it's a bad X-Men movie.
Especially if it's one of the bad X-Men movies. But so I watched Riverdale, and Brian and I played some Heroes of the Storm.
Mm-hmm. Is that event over now?
I think the event's still going. But it didn't take very long to, because you only have to play 15 games with Warcraft characters. And your friend doesn't have to play as a Warcraft character for you to get
really?
It. No,
oh.
you just have to play with a friend, and you have to be a Warcraft character to get your points.
Okay.
So, like, if we played together, you could play as Tracer, I could play as a
Warcraft
guy, and I could still get my stuff.
Yeah.
If you're like, I don't care about
it's
any
Tracer.
Of this junk.
Tracer.
Right. You can play as you want to play.
Yeah.
But when Brian and I first got on, everybody was pretty much Warcraft.
Yes.
Or Lucio.
Because
he
Ooh,
came out.
Oh, yeah, I need to get my Lucio. Yeah.
So that's the thing. It was Lucio and Warcraft people. And it was just like, okay. When we got on the other night, the teams were back to people playing as they wanted to play. And I was pretty much just trying out new heroes and stuff that I hadn't played before because I had to play as StarCraft heroes. That was one of my daily quests.
Oh.
Yeah. So I played as one guy, and Brian and I ended up... We ended up with some really good teams.
Yeah,
and Brian and I are finally starting to learn...
Your synergy between?
Just, if we look at the team dynamic, and then we look at the other team, we can kind of go like, okay, we might get trounced this round.
Right.
Like, they have some bruisers, but oh man, we have this going on. Like, we can see where the rock,
protect...
paper, scissors go. Yeah. I've hit level 40.
Whoa. Is that a big comp?
That's it.
Yeah. Level cap?
Yeah.
Nothing.
I got 2,000 gold for it, and that called it, and then that was... But yeah, we had some really wicked games where we just played... Maybe it was... I don't know if it was Last Stand.
I don't remember anything about him.
University was a while ago now.
Yes.
But But no, Brian and I had some games where by the time we finished playing, we won so many times that night where we're like, we should have streamed this. Like, we played so well. We should have. But we honestly just started playing. And then we started talking. So we were chatting more just about personal stuff. Yeah. So we ended up not streaming just because we were like, oh, blah, 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 blah. Oh, blah, 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 blah.
Yeah,
blah,
I was
blah,
I was busy playing that night, too. So.
And if more people would have obviously joined, we would have streamed. But the fact that we were just kind of, we weren't talking about the game. We weren't talking about anything other than personal stuff.
Yeah.
We didn't stream just because of that. So we didn't stream it, but we really should have because we kicked a lot of butt. So Brian's like, just play the replay and we'll talk over that.
Yeah, you could do that. You can commentate over that.
Because we kicked a lot of butt. There were maps where Brian and I just, like, swept the entire top row as they were fighting on the bottom. And they're just like... And then all of a sudden they'd come up to the top and we'd just sweep the bottom. And the other people would go to the top just to defend, like... And then by the time they were over, it was like, how did we... They didn't take any of our towers. Mm-hmm. There were maps where they didn't even... They touched, like, our wall.
Oh, wow.
And we're like...
Maybe they were just not on the ball either, too. A combination of you guys being wicked and...
But, and the, this was the other part. When we played the Warcraft stuff, you had all the World of Warcraft people coming. So it was like when you popped in to get Overwatch stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Going, I don't know what I'm doing. We had all these World of Warcraft people popping in. Who didn't know what they were doing. So we did roll a couple of those maps. But then we got rolled because we had the same people on our team. This map, like this time, it was 40, like level 40 versus level 40.
Mm-hmm.
And we just had that upper hand the entire match where, yeah, everything was just jiving between every... Like, we all knew where we were kind of supposed to be, and it was like, nope, to heck with it, I'm going to go do this. Mm-hmm. And at one point we were behind and came back. Like, it got to the point where we were just confused as to why we were winning. Mm-hmm. And then we lost one game because one of our guys decided not to actually move.
Yeah, those AFKers are the worst.
He didn't even AFK, so at one point it was Stitches. Big guy with the gut.
Oh, okay.
And he's a lot like...
Is that the one where, like, you get two kills if you get him?
Or no, that's Shogal. That's he's because he's two players. This guy plays, like... Is it Rotgut in Overwatch with the chain?
Oh, Roadhog.
Roadhog. He plays like him. He has the big chain.
Yep.
And he was legitimately... He'd crawl into a corner and try and chain us so that he would trap us because he's still a physical thing that we can't move through.
Mm-hmm.
He would try... Like, he trapped me in the corner of this hedge and I had to hearth back to base and run back into battle because he kept, like, trying to chain us over. And then he would just stand there and die if they came after him, like the other team. So we're just like, what the hell? Like, we're all reporting him and just, like... So... Yeah, we had those kind of issues on that game. But other than that, I haven't been doing a whole lot.
Yeah.
But yeah, Renowned Explorers, fun game. Check it out. Totally.
Put it on your wish list, basically.
Yeah, wait for it to go on sale and then pick that puppy up, because it's a fun little game to spend some time on. So that's what I've been doing.
Yep. Well, other than the Overwatch that we had earlier this week.
Which is on YouTube.
It is on YouTube.
You can watch us die a lot.
Yes.
We had one
you,
good
you have the news class playing on your TV. That's awesome.
Ooh.
That's next level. That's next level TV watching.
It's funny when I go on to my smart TV to get to our Google Play stuff, we have to go through YouTube.
Yes.
And it's obviously logged into my YouTube account. So it pops up going like, what you should watch next? Barrel Roll News? And I'm like,
no.
No, I think I've got this.
I think I know. Legion is... I don't know and understand the backstory of Legion. All I know is that he's a kid of Professor X's kid.
Yeah.
That's all I know about him.
That's all. Legion's one of those shows that I
don't know if it's going to succeed or not.
I don't have time right now to watch.
I also don't have enough interest in it.
And I have to find it because I don't know.
FX.
I don't even know if I get FX.
I'd have to find it.
Which is not... difficult.
It's not.
But I have to
it's
go.
Hassle.
I have to go out of my way to do it now, and it's just like yeah. By the time I get home from work and stuff, I'm just
like for me, I already have a like my jive of what I need to find. Yeah. Like Tuesdays, it's these ones. Wednesdays, it's these ones. And then other than those days, I don't really want to follow up after that. Apparently,
we appreciate him too.
Yes. Legends of Tomorrow got moved to like Tuesday, which threw me off.
Yeah, because now it's after...
After Flash. Thanks. You're welcome.
So.
I was at a league challenge for Pokemon on Wednesday. Yes. So I got a new deck. I was playing. I didn't do very well on it. But
Tony, how are we expected to like count on you to
raise funds for us? I built this deck, and I played 5 games with it. There was 5 games in that league challenge.
Oh, well, there you go.
So, yeah, it's got time to build, so I will work on it some more. It's got Ho-Oh, it's got Tauros in it, it's got some heavy hitters in it. So I will figure what it is. We went to a new gaming store, basically, because they moved out of Bonnie Doon. All Stars
moved, yes.
Yes, so they moved by Wagner.
Yes, they did. And I saw that on their Facebook.
Yes, and so thought I'd check out the new store. It is a nice big location there.
And
so,
how is Paul doing? The owner.
I'm trying to remember him, because I had met him. This was the first time I'd ever met him.
Mm.
He was okay, but he was very busy.
Now,
because the new store, he does a lot of stuff there.
I used to work in the same mall as Paul. I was in All Star Sports quite a bit. Then that mall got tore down. So
what mall?
So
you need a movie recommendation? No, none of those.
They're actually not too bad.
I don't. Really? What kind of movie do you want to watch?
Yeah, that's the big question.
Hoot and Roaster.
Are you looking for a...
Action, comedy, horror? I don't know. Let us know what kind of movie you want to watch.
Yes.
We can provide some better insight.
Trolls.
No.
I'm more into crime thrillers.
What would be considered a crime thriller? Like, what, Gotham?
I'm assuming
that's
whatever
a TV
that
show, but like
whatever that Johnny Depp movie is, Public Enemy would be a crime kind of thriller.
Oh, The Departed.
Departed would probably be close to that.
Taken, yeah, Taken's pretty good. Taken, like yeah, the first two are
you can watch all the Taken movies.
They're tacky.
Marathon. I like Seven. Love that movie. Seven mm-hmm. was good. I don't know of any good crime thrillers that have come out recently.
Would Winter Soldier be considered a crime thriller, or is that more of
no,
a...
No, that's an espionage movie. Espionage yeah, thriller. Public espionage. Because that Ben Affleck movie that just came out is a crime kind of flick, but that's still in theaters.
Oh, The Accountant.
Yeah.
You can find that now. I'm sure you can find it. Death Note. That Death Note's not much of a crime thriller. It's more of an anime fan thing.
We can branch out. People can branch out.
Yes, you can.
John Wick. Again.
That's just action. Yeah. That's just pure action. That's no crime. The only crime in that is that there's not more of them.
Yeah, oh, there Departed, we go. Usual Suspects.
Oh, Reservoir Dogs.
Reservoir Dogs.
How do we miss that? Really, Memento's considered a...
You know what? Go old school and just watch Pulp Fiction.
I'm surprised Memento is considered.
Fargo.
Yes, Fargo.
Go watch Fargo. I love Fargo.
So yeah, we went to All Star. That was a cool night. I played some Final Fantasy 15.
You did?
Apparently, the 30 seconds that Stand By Me was in the entire hour and 45 minutes was copyrighted. Even though I don't think any lyrics was ever saying in that bit. So, but Final Fantasy 15 is out. Well, finally. I can actually say that it's an actual game. and it looks really good. It's probably one of the best looking games I've ever seen. Like, in terms of open world aesthetic, character models, the way the game runs. It's really, really good.
And, well, that's good.
And honestly, and the game starts off with a sort of like a 15 years in the future, this happens kind of thing.
Oh.
So it's one of those like time jumpy story moments.
So you know something's coming,
yeah,
but
something
you don't
big
know
is
how
happening.
It comes.
Yeah, and so I only played about 2 hours of it. Hopefully I'll be able to get some more time before Zelda comes out this week. And yeah, like a lot of it was just driving around the countryside. Unfortunately, the car driving is pretty limited to the road. You can't just go off-roading with it.
You can't Mad Max it.
You can't just go Grand Theft Auto. And as Jake pointed out, Grand Theft Auto Final Fantasy last night, it is basically, yes, Grand Theft Auto Final Fantasy.
That's not a bad thing.
No, it is not, actually. The combat is, if you are used to Final Fantasy combat, take everything you know about it and throw it out the window.
Okay.
Because it is basically an action game at this point. You hold the circle button, and depending on where the left analog stick goes, it changes your attack. But you're just holding circle down. Huh. And then your attacks change. And of course, you can change different weapons. You got a different sword. There's a Buster type sword where it was like, you know, three times the size of the character.
Oh,
that,
Buster.
You know, swung around and knock things on their ass. You've got a javelin that did a little bit less damage, but it was much quicker. So you can switch up your combat.
Yeah.
The blocking, again, there's really no blocking in this game until it tells you that, you know, press the square button to block. And then you can do a fancy parry right after that. But if you hold the square button, you will always dodge every attack until your mana runs out. Because a lot of things run on mana.
See, that's not a bad thing.
No.
And I wouldn't call it mana at that point anymore. No. But
They still call it MP because it is Final Fantasy. Yeah. They just have to keep it that way. Once in a while, you get warp strike points where you can basically warp, not out of the battle, but sort of get a bird's eye view of the combat as your other NPC players are fighting the monster. And then you can just warp strike and do a little bit more damage, which I thought was kind of cool. Story-wise, it really falls in line with that Kingsglaive movie that they released, which I thought was really, really good. No Sean Bean in the game, even though he voices the same character in the movie, but it's not in the game. And then same thing with Lena Headey. She plays a character in the movie,
yeah,
but the same character isn't portrayed by the same voice actor in this game.
Oh.
It's very jarring, because I was, very used to Sean Bean and
Lena Headey. Because you've watched a movie.
Yeah. And then, really, you really do need to watch the movie before playing this game, I would say. And it's not a bad thing. I mean, the movie was fantastic. It was a great-looking movie.
Yeah.
And the story was better than any of the other Final Fantasy movies that existed out there. But yeah, like, the story was very well contained, at least in the first 2 hours that I played with it. I fed a cat. I spent a good chunk of the last portion of the stream trying to feed a cat.
Yep.
Because you need to fish for food. It was one of the side quests.
Sure.
As you can probably imagine, one of those open world games, there's a lot of side quests you can pick up. And one of them was, you know, I found a cat that was very picky. And it only wanted a specific type of fish. So I spent like 30 minutes trying to figure out how the fishing works.
oh dear.
And, you know, it was fun for while it lasted. But yeah, I want to put some more time in, because I didn't get much combat in the game. And it's a Final Fantasy game. You want to be flashy. You want to have to see flashy summons, that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
There's no loading in the game that I can see.
Wow, just...
Just the original, like the first load from the first chapter. Like, I think between chapters there's loads.
Sure.
But there's enough to do in each chapter from what it feels like that you don't need to wait a long time.
Well, and the big trick with a lot of loading, which some games have figured out, is if you hide it behind a movie,
mm-hmm.
or you hide it behind a different animation, like some people just, it's like stock loading screen, and you're like, okay. Mm-hmm. But if you think back to the first Mass Effect, where every time you went down that elevator that was your loading screen. Yep. And you're just like...
I think Batman did that too.
The Metroid Prime games did that when you shot the doors. Like, as you approach doors, that's when it was loading. Like, there's ways to
disguise it.
Disguise the loading where... Mm-hmm.
I think, though, they didn't really beat around the bush for Final Fantasy XV, that it's just the chapter one loads.
Yeah.
Go.
Well, and a lot of times, too, there's the procedural loading stuff, too. Like, if you look at World of Warcraft,
mm-hmm.
same thing. It's not like it's loading the entire world. No. But you can seamlessly run from, like, A to point B.
And a lot of modern games do a lot of culling.
Yeah.
Where it only loads what you see.
Right.
And then when you turn around, it kind of kicks the stuff out of memory and loads what's behind you.
Yeah.
As you're turning the camera around. And that's what a lot of modern games are doing nowadays.
Yeah. And it's saving a lot on that.
Oh, yeah. Memory and processing power. I watch a lot of Barrier Break
on
YouTube. It's a YouTube channel. You should guys definitely go check it out after this. Basically, and support him, because what he does is fantastic. He actually goes into games and then kind of rips the camera off of the analog stick and then brings the camera around to see, like, oh, is this castle from Zelda actually loaded? No. No, it's not. And so what he does on his channel is fantastic. Go take a look at it, because some of the stuff you don't realize gets loaded into the games. For example, he did a episode with Wind Waker.
Yep.
What's that dragon on top of that mountain again? I can't remember.
Yes.
But he actually boundary broke into the mountain.
Yep.
And had they actually loaded his whole tail into the game, his tail would have clipped out of the mountain. So what the developers did was they cut the tail in half.
Yep.
And then shrunk the tail. And so as he flew up, they expanded the tail as the animation required it, which was super cool. You would never see that I love watching that kind of stuff, and I'm sure Final Fantasy 15 does all that stuff.
So, but yeah, that's the
yard work sucks.
I do not like yard work.
No.
But yeah, that's the cool thing. Like, even doing, like, even the intro videos for what we do here, just the dumb things where you're like, if I squeak this down here and it expands this way and goes up this way, I can hide, like, 800 other steps.
It's one. It's funny to fear, like, playing games now and realizing how games are actually made.
Yeah.
Because that channel really opened my eyes.
That is, well, even like, movies. Making movies, making games is like math. You want to find the fastest, easiest, shortest,
least crashiest,
like least amount of effort almost way to get there.
Mm-hmm.
But still have to, you have to have a polished game on the other side of it. But
and then on the other hand, it's like, oh, we really wanted this cutscene to have this character in it. So, you know, we obviously had him in there, but all of a sudden we didn't want him in there. So we deleted him, but then the scene crashed.
Right.
Obviously, you know, we have to figure out how to make that scene go without that character. So they just had him behind a wall.
House of Cards. Do you ever watch House of Cards?
No, not even a little bit.
I could never get into it. That's some guy that one of them was asking. Yeah. I have to scroll up here.
House of Cards.
Putin Roasters.
House of Cards. I know if you really like the political thriller stuff.
Yeah.
It's totally up your alley.
Yeah, I started watching it, and I...
Like, it is not my cup of tea, but
Kevin Spacey is brutal in that show.
Yeah, but he's also brutal in everything he does.
He can be. Sometimes he doesn't. Sometimes he plays, like, the really dumb kid. He was a cat in a movie. Like, let's face it.
Yeah, that's true. But that's a voiceover work.
So. I know, but that's what I mean. Like, Kevin Spacey does weird, weird things. But that's House of Cards I tried watching.
Yeah.
I never got into it. But yeah, Kevin Spacey was good. Not my cup of tea.
And I...
Good show.
He was one of the most recent Call of Duty games too, and he was excellent in that as well.
That's Kevin Spacey.
So, except for Game of Thrones, this is a throne. Let's play some games on it.
Graham.
We need him.
Graham. Chris. Graham.
We don't watch Game of Thrones.
We're really bad at that.
We don't. I tried watching the first season, and I got upset when Sean Bean's character died inevitably, and I didn't care. After that,
Game of Thrones was one of those. I just HBO shows I don't get into.
I was watching the Slenderman documentary, which was really cool to watch. I mean, I can't really talk about it because it was off to the side. Having the strongest man in the world. Oh yeah, the Mountain. I know about that guy. I know about him through basically viral Twitter and viral.
Yeah, I know. We're bad.
I'm not even.
I'm bad with HBO shows. I still have, The Sopranos is one of those ones that I want to still watch.
Again, I don't care about Sopranos enough.
And The Sopranos to me, because I do like those kind of films, like, when we are asking, like, I loved The Departed.
Yeah.
And The Sopranos is just one of those, it was a brutal show for 7 years of, like, how these mobsters lived.
Yeah.
So it's one of my things. Oh, yeah. Oh, absolutely.
Daredevil. Okay, wait. We watched the Netflix Daredevil and enjoyed it.
Chris is telling us right now that Game of Thrones is amazing.
Chris is... Well, I'm not contesting... Do not confuse our lack of interest of Game of Thrones for...
Yeah, no, not saying
it's not
bad.
Being a bad show. It is a good show.
Yes.
We just don't watch it. I respect it as a show. I understand why people like it. It's a, you know, visually, it's a great show.
Thematically cool.
Half naked chicks.
Totally.
Sure. That's a great show. Same thing with Walking Dead. Walking Dead is I'm the same thing like that. I respect it as a show. I won't watch it because I've just
stuff happens after the tank.
It's horses. Horses.
Every time we talk about Game of Thrones or not Game of Thrones, Walking Dead. That's I got to the tank.
Daredevil, we really enjoyed the Netflix one. The Ben Affleck one was passable.
Chris is saying you should probably try to watch it more then.
Watch what?
Yes.
I'm not going to watch them more. I've got too many other shows to really keep up on already.
Again, I am too lazy to look up like a show that just started. Never mind. A show that I have to catch up so many seasons.
Well, and that's the thing. Like, I've got a personal limit. Once a show has reached like 3 seasons, I know if I might enjoy it. Well, that was weird.
I bet.
Yes. They're pulling the Clone Wars from Netflix. Oh. No.
That's okay. I'm done. I finished Clone Wars.
I'll read about it later. And Luke Cage. I think Luke Cage.
I liked Luke Cage.
I like Luke Cage way more than Jessica Jones.
Me too. And people online were very opposite to that. There was a lot of people online that were very opposite to that thought process.
I think, though, like, Luke Cage is really, really good.
Yep.
Though it's not... Right now is not the right time for it to be successful because it's such a small niche sort of storyline. In the greater scheme of the Defenders, it will be popular. Like, yeah. he still needs room to build that Luke Cage character.
Oh, so much. But so, I thought they did such a good job of building everything
in Luke Cage. The community.
And I felt the community. I felt the world. It felt really authentic. I felt the world in Luke Cage.
It felt really real, very authentic.
Luke Cage is awesome.
So, what got me into it?
Yeah, well, Clone Wars is good, but you can still find it.
Luke Cage was way racy, racist.
Well, except it was made by African American.
It was all. If you ever go to that sort of Harlem neighborhood,
yeah,
that's what you're gonna see.
Yeah, that was the point.
And that's what they wanted
to bring Harlem to the people.
Yeah, Iron Fist is. I'm excited. Yeah, Iron Fist can be something very special. I think that's going to be.
If it's like the other shows, it's going to be.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Like even at its worst, Jessica Jones was still watchable.
Really good show.
It was still watchable.
Yeah.
Though
I just didn't get into it as much. Like Daredevil, I sunk into and.
Holy cow!
Like,
they hit that one out of the park.
But to be, like with Luke Cage. I have people that I work with that do not comic book and watch Luke Cage.
Yes.
Like, they did not watch Daredevil, they did not watch Jessica Jones, they hopped into Luke Cage, and one, he's a good-looking dude.
Yes.
Two, in my mind, because that was what caught it for me, was the music was incredible.
Yes.
I can't listen to it without, like, you know, without getting weird looks.
But Iron Fist is going to be...
Okay, Atlas. I hate having to do this kind of stuff, but... Off to the Twitch I go.
Okay.
We don't appreciate that, Atlas.
That's not... Read, if you're on Twitch, there's some rules.
There are some rules.
So, I do not... You don't like Daredevil? And that's perfectly fine.
But that's the beauty of...
And that's perfectly fine. You don't have to like every superhero in the world.
Yeah.
I mean, like, my favorite hero doesn't exist in the Marvel Universe. So, you don't... I mean, like... That's just how it is.
Oh, I'm on. How am I logged in that I can't do things? Tony.
What?
What's going on?
You're logged in.
I know I'm logged in. Who am I logged in as? Us?
You're logged in as you.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
See, it's in the little corner on the bottom.
Yeah, I can see. We're good. Oh, viewer list. There it is. I found it.
Okay.
So, yeah,
Luke Cage is good. Iron Fist is going to be... There's going to be some potential.
And yeah, like, that's my biggest, there we go. Ah, I found it.
Yep.
And yeah, that's the beauty of all that stuff is you don't have to like it. I think Marvel trying to do all these different shows, though, because that's...
You get something all the way as crazy as Luke Cage, all the way to Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yep.
To things like Doctor Strange. Like, you've got so many different things out there that there's something for everyone. And if you like to happen, if you happen to like all of them... it's just extra, you know. By single comic books. Where I live, there's only big comic books available. I think he means trades.
Yeah, you're thinking trade paperbacks. Our city has
tons of
a bunch of places you can buy comic books. So, you can even go to our library and get comic books.
Maybe online, you can look online. If you've got like an iPhone or an iPad or something like that, you can...
There you go, on hero.com.
Yeah. Right. But if you've got like a tablet or something like that, you can buy... get the Marvel Unlimited subscription, which is apparently pretty good.
I was going to say, I use Marvel Unlimited. I feel bad about doing because I'll sign up for a month.
Mm-hmm.
I'll read through everything I want to read, and then I unsubscribe.
See, my big thing is there's no Windows 10 app for it for my tablet, or else I would have already been signed up.
Yeah.
And of course, I'm not going to read comics on my phone.
No, you need
a
tablet.
That's a bad idea.
But yeah, I definitely do. I'm a horrible, horrible person where I'm like...
But you pay for it. That's exactly how you used it. That's not...
Well, and again, they're making more money off of me than they would if I bought my singles. Because that is what I do. I do buy... I used to buy singles before they destroyed the Ultimate Spider-Man line by killing off Peter Parker. But Yeah, our city has... Well,
we have lots.
We live in Edmonton, we have up in Canada.
We have about like 5 or 6 different stores, at
easily.
Least.
Easily.
At least.
And big ones.
Yes.
Not just like...
Mom-and-pop stores.
Mom-and-pop shops that sell like, you know, and they have the little rack of comics that you can go around. No, this is like, you walk in and
hobby
it's...
Store. It's hobby store grade.
Oh, yeah.
It's hobby store
grade. Well, I mean, 3 of them are connected, but...
Yeah. I don't count that 3rd one in that connection.
No. But either way, yeah, so okay. Thanks.
Yeah.
Cool. Thanks, Greg, because I've never tried to get them online, because we've always just had
digital
them available
stuff.
In the city
yeah.
if I wanted
trade. Since library. Yeah, check your local library. The library might have
try
them
out.
But other than that, I haven't really done anything other than Final Fantasy, some Pokemon, some Overwatch. I did find Moana again, so I rewatched that. It's a good movie.
It's coming out soon. Rogue One's coming out soon.
Oh, yeah, Rogue One.
These things? From the Golden? No, I don't.
Oh, that's them. Yeah.
I still remember Tony and I went to a comic expo. And the guy had Amazing Fantasy 15, like the first appearance of Spider-Man.
Wasn't it like absurdly.
It was in really good condition. Not even really good. I think it was like in the comic book scale, like 8 something, like, which is still good.
Yes.
And he's like, how much do you think that is? And I just jokingly was like, $1,000, because if it was, I would have gotten it. But like,
no, it was way more than that.
That was a big, the most expensive comic I own is the first issue of Ultimate Spider-Man with a very limited run of the cover.
Oh, you have variant?
I have a variant cover.
Oh, yeah.
I've looked it up, and it is mint. It hasn't been opened. It hasn't, like, I bought it, you know, like, solid. It's in mint, and it's apparently, from what I've looked up, worth like $250. But that's it. Mm. Like, my comic book collection extends to that, and whatever's up there. Some of those are kind of cool.
They're I don't have many comics. I have a growing pile of Spider-Gwen comics I need to be reading. But other than that, I don't do the physical comics. I do the digital comics.
I haven't done physical comics since Ultimate Spider-Man went to poop. I bought some Superior Spider-Man comics just to kind of read them, but then I found
Superior was pretty cool.
Superior was an interesting storyline.
Yeah,
I liked the way it started. I liked the way it ended.
See, I thought the way it ended was a bit of a cop out.
But you knew it was coming.
It had to come, but it was such.
But the way they did it, I thought was just perfect with him fighting the Green Goblin. Like it worked out really well. For my mind, is that's how he comes back. Is Doc Ock all of a sudden discovers that like oh. I don't actually have what it takes to be
a hero.
He can be a really good vigilante of sorts, but he can't be the hero. Like, he cannot sacrifice his own life to save the day, whereas Peter Parker is
he's
willing and ready.
He's done that a few times.
Yes. He's ready to jump in front of the explosion to
I like the concept behind the Totally Awesome Hulk comics. I like where they're going with it.
Yep.
I don't know that it's going to pick up a lot of traction.
I honestly haven't read them. I cannot comment on Totally Awesome Hulk.
I know that when I was reading some of the old man storyline, old man Logan storyline, when Logan comes back, he's like, oh, I gotta fight the Hulk because, you know, the Hulk gang.
Yeah.
He's like, you're not the Hulk. Yeah, no, and he was totally, like, a completely cognant.
Yes, he's a very different Hulk.
Yes, very different Hulk.
It's
super, super different.
Also Asian.
Yes, Korean. Is he Korean?
Korean, I think.
Yeah, something like that.
As Marvel gets into their, like, changing every hero into either a different sex or culture. Yeah.
Not in white.
Which is cool. It's just, like, they really... It's noticeable, Marvel. Like, it wasn't, like, a casual change. It was just, like, now we have all these people.
Because it basically started with Ms. Marvel, right? I think... I want to say it started with her. Because she was... I mean, they've done it in the past, obviously. But, like, Ms. Marvel changed, did Thor, or was Thor before or after that? Because they changed Thor to a she. I don't remember if it was before or after, but it was in that same...
That's what I mean, it happened so fast, like, everything just started...
And then you got a black Iron Man, black female Iron Man.
Yeah.
Who I think is doing okay.
Yeah.
No, actually, Miles Morales probably started all of that.
The half African American, half Hispanic.
Yes, I think that pretty much started it all.
And here's my thing. I'm happy that they, like, when they killed Peter Parker off, I'm like, woof, because that hit. Like, you're going, whoa, that's a big jump to take. When they brought Miles Morales in, I was excited. And then they gave him the exact same backstory with all the exact, like, they changed nothing. They essentially just made Peter Parker younger again, and then gave him the minority stuff going on. And you're going, give him a different story. Like, make something different happen. And it took them a while to finally find their footing and actually try and challenge stuff and make stuff happen.
Yep.
And then that's when the comics started getting good, but by then they had lost, like, they lost me at that point.
Okay.
Well.
So, Miles did not do that. He got bit by a radioactive, or not a radioactive, a genetically altered spider from Oscorp that his uncle stole. So, okay, there's the difference there. He wasn't on a field trip. Then he got the speech of, with great power comes great responsibility from Gwen Stacy at Peter Parker's funeral. It was later on that when all of a sudden his dad kicks him out and his mom dies and, like, all this stuff starts. That's where it changes, and that's where it got good, but that took way too long to happen. It wasn't original enough in the beginning, and it took too long to get original. Mm. For me, in my...
I just don't care enough about that character, but I'm glad he exists.
Yes, but especially especially after a great Peter Parker run with Ultimate Spider-Man, that's where I was just like, oh, Miles is kind of a letdown. He's gotten better now.
Okay.
Surveys upon the North God. Sorry from North. Loosely.
Yeah, very.
Super loose.
Yeah.
Then it would be a small spider running around with manpower? Is that
man spider?
Oh.
Okay.
Either who, folks, we do need to shut down because yes, we have places to be and hands to kiss and. The opposite of that, which I'm not going to say on...
We're going to kick some butt.
Yes.
Is what we're going to do. Okay, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for watching. Sorry, our YouTube didn't work. We'll make sure all of our videos do end up there, though.
Yeah, we're going to just push it up.
We'll push from Twitch.
Twitch has got that thing. Yeah. And again, not really our fault. From early reports, not ours.
Yes.
So.
Thanks for joining us, though, guys. Hopefully there will be more of us next week that we can carry on more of a conversation. And, of course, next week... If all goes well with shipping and posting,
we'll see.
We'll have a Switch.
We'll look at it.
And hopefully by then I can have
a
Bomberman or something that we can play. Yes. Like honestly, 1-2 Switch would be amazing for this.
Yes.
So, we'll see. Either who, folks, thanks for watching.
Thanks for joining. Yeah, you guys can keep chatting in the chat if you want. I think it still goes if you guys want.
I think
want.
It still goes once we log off. So,
so you guys can hang out for a little bit while. We've got a Discord
we do
log into as well. We're going to fire the link off into there. You can join there. Join it. We've got Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, again.
Yep.
As much as we can on YouTube, anyways. Like us, share with your friends. Subscribe to us everywhere.
All this information is available at www.BrNN.com.
Where you can also find our profiles.
Yes.
On our things that we do.
The Twitter and the Steam. That would be good to have a Switch. It would be really good to have a Switch. I'm telling you right now.
Well, next week's going to be either incredibly interesting or incredibly boring.
Depending on what shipment Nick gets and how good Canada Post is.
It's not good.
They've been good to me. So I'm not going to badmouth them.
They've been passable to me.
They've been excellent to me. I'm going to leave a note, though, on my door.
Leave a real big note.
It's going to be, dear Canada Post.
I'm here.
Please do this. Here are instructions as follows. Signature. And Jake, we will definitely check out your game.
Yes, some more.
Later.
Yep. We just have a time thing to do.
We do. So either who, thanks for watching, folks.
Good evening.
Have a lovely...
Or morning.
Yes, have a lovely morning and or afternoon.
I hope this was better news than your local news.
Hopefully. Either who. Thanks for watching, guys.
Goodbye.
See you next week.